Hello and welcome back to Chubby Pug Yarn Podcast. This is episode 13. Yay! So I have made myself a cup of hot tea. I have been out walking with the dogs, so now I'm ready to record. Today it's Saturday, 28th. Yes. I always forget to like note down the date. Saturday, sunny and beautiful. We had like the last week, we have had like really crazy weather. We have had sunny and warm, and then it suddenly became cold and we got like 20 centimeters of snow. But now today it's warm and sunny again. So I have been out with the dogs for a walk, enjoying sunlight and warmth. And since it's such a nice weather, I can always use my Riddari Icelandic sweater. Maybe I should show it sometime. It's the most used knit I have, I think. But anyways, I thought I should record a little episode today. I haven't been doing crazily much knitting. So I thought that today would be be a nice episode for the baby knits that I talked about last episode, that maybe I should do. And I got some responses that said, yeah, please talk about it. So I will do that later, but first I can show you some of my progress. I haven't been monogamous with any knitting, so I haven't finished anything, but I have made some progress, at least. I could start with the Calavera mittens, which I have in my gorgeous Walking Dead bag. And I have made a lot of progress since you last saw it last week. So here is the pattern coming up really nicely. I really love how the blue and green turns up in the knitting. So the only alteration I have made so far is, like in most mittens I've seen, they tell you to bind off stitches and then pick, like, make new ones. And I'm never satisfied with how the picked up edge becomes. So what I do is, when I come to the end of the thumb, I knit in a piece of scrap yarn, and then I knit, put the stitches back on the left needle, and then I knit the patterning that's supposed to be above the thumb, and then I can pick them up and I have a hole with all the stitches live. I think it's easier because then I can try it. I don't get the ugly edge that I get when I bind off and then pick up stitches. So that's what I do. I think these mittens will be quite big, because now, last time I showed it, I was down here and I have been knitting all this, and now it's time to do the creases. But as you can see, it's not so far up. So I'm not sure if these mittens will be too long for me, but my boyfriend is looking at them as soon as I pick them up. He's like, oh, these are so pretty. I want them. I want them. So if they turn out too big for me, at least he can have them, because who doesn't want mittens with skulls, right? But I'm really, really pleased with how the patterning is turning out. And since we still have snow and windy sometimes, it's nice to have mittens when you're out walking the dogs late at night or in early mornings. And I have made some nice progress on the bobble set. So now I have made all the rows of bubbles that is supposed to be before the arm holes. So now I need to knit two arms and then connect it all together. So, but it's really quick and I really, really like how the fabric is turning out. It's not very dense, but the bubbles make a really, really nice structure. It's more of an orange than yellow, because on my screen it looks yellow, but it's a little bit more orange. I'm thinking about having one row of a contrasting bubble color. I have some scraps from one of my other baby knits in the same yarn, Abuelita 4-ply merino, in a pale mint green. So I'm thinking about having one contrasting row just for so something interesting happens. But we'll see what I do. I had quite a lot of progress on this yesterday, Friday, because knitting with you, Frida, who has a podcast, had a weekend virtual knitting night. So we hang out and talked, and I was knitting on this. So now I am finished with this piece for a while and need to knit the arms. And the arms are supposed to be gray. I think they are stockinette. And then I need the bubbles on the front and back. So that's really fun to knit, and I can't wait, because then I need to knit pants and a hat to it. So it's really fun. And behind me I have the front piece on the Skapelganser. So there is the Brontosaurus for when I podcasted last, and this is how much I have knitted so far on the front. So quite a lot. My boyfriend was talking about the other day, he was talking about the fact that this, the new Game of Thrones episodes is coming up. And so he said, oh, maybe you should try to catch up so we can watch the new episodes together. So I'm trying to do that, and it's perfect to have just garter stitch, just knit back and forth, without thinking while I watch it. So the reason why I'm falling behind, I have fallen behind really bad. I have one season to catch up. That's because somehow when I watch scary or series that are a little bit unpleasant, I usually get nightmares. It sounds really silly, but I really like, I love watching Walking Dead. It's one of my favorites. But if I watch like too many episodes in a row, I start having nightmares about zombie apocalypse and me hunting zombies and zombies eating my pug. I don't remember it, except I get really tired, and then my boyfriend, who is, he's often up late, he talks to me because I like sit up, and says, oh, don't eat the pug. And he's like, oh, what's happening? He says, oh, the zombies are eating my pug. And then I fall asleep again. So, and the same thing with Game of Thrones. So I can't watch too many episodes in a row, but now I have been watching 2 or 3 episodes and I have been okay. So perhaps it's going better this time. I have a really hard time not fiddling with my hair. I went to the hairdresser this Thursday. So as you can see, it's shorter in the back. I had like this long before. So I'm trying to have some kind of spring haircut, but I'm not used to it, so I'm like fiddling around with it. But yeah, lot of babble. Blathering, blathering. I have been doing some crocheted squares. I didn't bring them up to show you because I don't think it's so interesting to say that I made this many squares that is purple. Because as I talked about at the weekend yesterday, my biggest problem with scrap blankets and stuff is that almost all my scraps are purple or maybe blue. So when I'm like trying to make the squares in my blankets, it's like, should I have the blue beside the blue or the purple beside the purple or another purple? So I'm trying to get some mini skeins so I can pop in some other colors than my blues and purples. I've made some of my No Makers mini skeins that they had like a random mini club. So I got, I think it's 2 or 3 episodes ago, I showed like some mini skeins in other colors than blue and purple. So I made some of those, and then I made some more blues and purples. I haven't like crocheted them to the blanket yet, so just a pile of squares. But anyway, it's a little bit of progress, one square at a time. So, and I haven't been spinning almost nothing this week, so I have no progress to show you, unfortunately. But yeah, that's how it is. In my other craft session, I can proudly present Elements of Love. Completely finished. I love you! It's so cute! So now I need to find a frame for it. Yeah, I told you last time, as you can see, this is not centered at all in this direction. But that's because I thought that it was going to be bigger until I discovered the problem with the count wasn't the same as I thought it was. So, lesson learned, but I think it's really cute anyways, so I need to find some cute frame for it. I haven't found any frame for the Tyrannosaurus, the T-Rex one either, but I hopefully find. I'm watching in stores when I'm out shopping, and I haven't found anything yet, but it will probably come. And the dogs are snoring like really loud. And I actually had some, I got something in my mail today that fits my stash a lot. And actually it fits well to about me talking Walking Dead. In February, Desert Vista Dye Works had 2 colorways in her series. She makes like a series of colorways themed for Walking Dead. So I think I'm not really sure if the colorway, if they kill Rick, was the first one. I didn't got that one. But in February, 1st of February, I got 2 new colorways from her Walking Dead series. And I received them in my mail today. So here is If They Kill Carol. It's really, really gorgeous. It's dark reds some greens and orange and yellows and some hot pink and pale pink. It's self-striping. I think it's four stripes, if I remember correctly. It's on her Viso base. Let's see. It's 75% superwash merino wool and 25% nylon, 462 yards approximately. So that will be a little bit over 400 meters. So that's one colorway. I will see if I will knit it up to this colors. Reminds me a little bit more of my mother's colors than me, so maybe I should knit her a pair of Walking Dead socks. I don't know, maybe. And I also got If They Kill Daryl colorway, which is black, gray, green, and blue. It's really gorgeous too. I love her yarn. I have only knitted my Frank and Somebody socks yet, but I really love them. My boyfriend stole them, so he uses them because he really loves my hand knit socks. I feel mostly honored. So this will probably be a pair of socks for me if he doesn't take them from me. It's one of the bad or slash good things with having almost the same size. I have quite huge, for women's size, I have quite big feet, and he has quite small feet on the other hand. Because I use, like in shoe sizes, I use European 41. I believe, is that 6.5 or 7 in UK? I'm not sure. 7 maybe. And he uses 42, so one size more. So probably 7.5 UK size. I'm not really sure about shoe sizes, even though I work a lot with shoes, I always forget. But we have almost the same size. So when I knit socks that fits me, they fit him really well too. And this is a colorway that both of us would like to have, I think, because he really liked the other pair of socks I made. But blues and greens maybe are more my colors, so maybe I can hem them for myself. The If You Kill the Carol, the red one, is actually more his colors, but I'm not sure if he like the orange and pinks. He's more of red colors. I'm more of purple and blue, as you probably have understand by now. Understood by now. Grammar. Yeah. So that's all I have had in my stash a lot section. I have actually ordered some more zombie colorways from Desert Vista Dye Works, but I bet they will not be here for like another month at least. And now it's a little bit more time. The next No Makers Mini Skein Club set will not be here yet either, so I don't think I have any mail coming for a while. But anyways, I have quite a lot of stash to knit from, so I'm not I don't have a yarn starving period in front of me. I have a lot of knitting to do, so and today I also wanted to mention, I do this like little bit now and then, but I want to like do a formal recommendation. I posted on Instagram recommending two quite new podcasters. So I thought about doing a reel mentioning here in the podcast too. The first is Nathan, probably. Sorry for that. Who has the Sockmatician podcast, like mathematician but with sock instead of math. He has two episodes up, I think. Quite long, which I like, and he's really pleasant to listen to, and he makes gorgeous double knitting projects. He showed like this humongous shawl that he had knitted, and I was really fell in love with the shawl. I was like, oh, I want to learn. I have never done double knitting, but now I'm like, I want to make that one. I want that one, but unfortunately there is no pattern for it yet, so maybe I should try some other things first. But if you haven't heard about Sockmatician podcast, check it out. It's a great podcast. And also Kemper, who has a Young Yarn podcast. I think she has a little bit, she have about, could be 7 episodes up or something, 8, I'm not really sure. She has a really, really nice podcast, I think. She's also very, very pleasant to listen to. I feel a lot of... I recognize a lot of myself in how she talks about knitting and things, when she talks about things, how she sees things and think about stuff, and I feel like recognizing myself a lot, and she's a lot of fun also, so I really, really recommend her podcast, Young Yarn. So check her out if you haven't, and if you have, you know what I'm talking about. So that's all of my progress and podcast love and mail stuff. And I still have two very tired dogs, so then I can talk a little bit about my baby knits that I've done. I think it's a little bit over a year ago I made my first baby knit. The problem is I can't tell you if the patterns I have knitted are a good fit or appropriate for the sizes it's said, because I have never had any babies in these knitted stuff. I have this basket, which I keep my baby knits in, and hoping to find the perfect gift for the perfect baby. I see a lot of, for my knitting mojo, it's really, really pleasant to knit baby knits. Because you get like an instant gratification. You start knitting it, you buy the yarn, start knit, and like in 1 or 2 weeks it's finished. And when you give baby knits away, it's a really appreciated gift. So even though I haven't given so much things away, the things I have made have been very appreciated. The first thing I made was this one. This is, I think it's size 3 months. It's called Johannes Jacke, like Johannes Cardigan, probably, from Pickles. You will see a theme in my baby knits where I get the patterns from. It's brown and blue, light blue, and a dusty purple. And there is two rows of buttons, so it's not like one for show, it's actually two rows. And this really, really cute like shawl color. I think it's really, really cute. It's so tiny. One of the good things with many of their patterns, the pickles, is like for this, when if you have a baby with really long arms, you can just take the ribbing and fold it out, and you have like orangutan arms. And if you have a baby with really short arms, you can fold it double, so you get some alterations to do even after you have knitted it. This is made in Pickles Extra Fine Merino. So this is my first baby knit, and I am really proud of it. I thought the colors went together really well. I know when I was knitting this, I went to like a knitting night at my local yarn store, and they have had a like big debate whether this was a boy or a girl sweater. They was like, "Oh, who are you knitting it for?" And I was like, "Oh, I don't know. I'm knitting it because it's fun." And then they had big debates because it was purple in it, but the other hand, how the buttoning design was and stuff. But yeah, I don't care. I think it's pretty colors. They work good together, and I think a baby would fit perfectly in it. So yeah. And I got really bitten by the baby knitting bug when I knitted that Johannes cardigan. So I knitted Edith's everyday jumpsuit. So I think this one is size is 6 or 9 months maybe. So I have like a pale, really, really pale purple in the top. And then it's orange, let's see, orange and pale green, blue green. It's not actually that vibrant. Yeah, and it's asymmetric in the top. So, ribbing, so you can fit a baby chest in here. And you can fold the neck if you want to. And it was really fun because this was the first time I tried I-cord for the outside of the bottom band and for like the sleeves. I think it's a really nice way to end a garment for babies and probably for grown-ups too, I don't know. But it keeps it from like rolling up on itself. So yeah, I think it's really nice. And this was the first time I knitted with the Ableta 4-ply merino. I didn't fall in love with it so much as I have done now, but I thought it was really pleasant. So yeah, Edith's everyday jumpsuit. I will link all these patterns in my show notes as usual. I'm not sure how much you use like long sleeve and long leg jumpsuits for babies, but if maybe you do if it's cold. I just think it would be really, really cute anyways. And after that, I didn't knit so many baby knits for a while, and I have had a prescription for the UK magazine, The Knitter, I think it's called. And they had, when I got one of their magazines, and I was like, a little bit down on my knitting mojo. Didn't want to knit so much. And then I folded up the magazine and there was such a cute baby sweater. And I was like, oh my god, I want to knit it now. The pattern was called Ladybug on a Leaf. So in the magazine it was green with ladybug buttons. So I went for my stash, and actually I didn't have any green, but I had a heathery blue. So I knitted it up like this. This was the first sweater I tried knitting top down with this little bit of special raglan decrease. This is Ableta Merino Worsted, so it's really, really light and fluffy. And I found these really, really cute bee buttons. And also there's a little pocket. So I had to practicing like sewing the seams. The pocket is knit separately and then sewn on. So I had some practice with that. It's also one of the things I like about baby knits. I can try new yarn, I can try new techniques, and if it doesn't end well, I haven't spent like many hours with it. And this, the Ableta Merino Worsted yarn is probably one of my favorite yarns because it's very versatile in knitting gauge, because I think I knitted these on 6.5, and it's dense and nice anyways, and I have knitted small needles like 3.5, and it still looks nice and maybe a little bit more dense, but it doesn't get stiff or hard to knit or something. It's easy from small needles to big needles, and it looks gorgeous anyway. So I'm looking forward to give this to someone really cute. I think this is a size 2 years. The only baby knits I have been given away was one like sweater and pants called Fun Kit, I think. Moro Set from Pickles. I made it to my baby cousin. I don't have any pictures of her using it. And then this autumn I knitted the grandpa sweater in pink, a dusty pink, Pickles merino tweed with two strands that I knitted like sideways first time. So she got it for her Christmas present, and she really enjoyed having it because she was quite cold when it was like crazy cold in Sweden. But I don't have any pictures of them. That's one thing I learned. I need to take pictures of my knitted stuff before I give it away. And then Pickles got me again. I found the Lazy Daisy cardigan, and it's so freakingly cute. I think this is a size 3 months as well. I really liked the design for the color. The jagged edge looks really pretty with this yarn, and this is some special stitch. They call it Daisy Stitch, but I'm not sure if it has any other name. So you can see this is in a pale purple. It's a spring green, some apricot color or something. It's a little bit more vibrant in reality. And this is also Pickles Extra Fine Merino yarn. It's one of my favorites for baby knits. It's so soft. There can't be any itch with it. It's the same yarn that I knitted the Rock the Lobster cardigan for Monica, my friend. Because it's so soft, so it works really well for baby knits. And with this, it actually is a little hat. So it's with the scraps from one of the stripes. And it's so small and so cute. Actually, I think about knitting several of these cute hats in my scraps, because I have almost a basket full of extra fine merino scraps. So maybe I should knit more of these hats, because I think they're really cute to give away. And then I went around on Ravelry this summer, and I found the Foxy Loxy jumper. This is my version. So let's see, this is the front. So this one I knitted in Sunness Alpaca yarn. So it has a little bit more of a halo. I don't know if you can see it. But anyways, it's really cute with all the foxes. And I really like the burnt orange color. I thought it was really, really nice. I think this is size 1 or 2 year. I'm not sure. It was quite interesting to see how the pattern was like, how the pattern was made to fit with like the creases and stuff. This one was knitted bottom up, if I'm not, yeah. But yeah, a baby sweater with foxes. Actually, I took some of the scraps for this and knitted a bear toy for my cousin. That's, I don't remember what the pattern was for the bear, but it has like this pale beige color as like face and hands, and then it has a blue and purple striped pajamas, and then I knitted a orange scarf for it. But when I gave it to her, the baby bear, or the bear toy, was as big as my baby cousin. So it was like big company in her bed. And then to what I think is one of my favorites. My boyfriend claims that the Johannes Jacke, the first baby sweater I knitted, is the best one in terms of color and design. But I really, really love this one. This is also from Pickles. It's called Oslo Anorak. So it's knitted in Abuelita Merino worsted. And I can tell you, if I was 2 years old, maybe 3 years old, I would totally want to have this, or I could knit in my own size. It has these contrasting colors. It's a multi-colored in greens, mint greens, purples, and some apricot. It's really, really pretty, and I fell in love with the, let's see, with the buttons I found. It works so well with the sweater. This one I actually was able to try. One of my friends has a baby boy who was 2 years when I tried this, and it fit him really well. So, but he's too big for it now. Yeah, I could totally have one of these for myself, because I love hoodies and I love this grey with this purple. The problem is the purple and mint one, the color does not exist anymore, so I can't knit I can't knit like complementing things to this or something else, which I feel a little bit sad about because I really, really think it was cute and I love the color. Yeah, but it's just turning side in the sofa. Yeah, now I have been talking and talking. I feel like this won't be a long episode. But hey, it is what it is. I'm doing this for fun, and if I haven't so much to talk about, I can't talk about more than I have. And this one I have already shown once. This is the baby sweater I knitted from my own design. I'm thinking about trying to re-knit it in bigger sizes and maybe write down a pattern for it. But I'm not sure if it's a design that anyone else would like. So I'm not sure. But it's also a Velita Merino 4-ply I knitted in it. With a garter stitch body, top down. But since I can't try it on, I don't know any small children, I can't try it on anyone, then it feels hard to like design for baby sizes when I'm not sure how big a baby is or not. So it would be really, really fun to like evolve this to a pattern in different sizes. Maybe I can have it like a autumn project, maybe. Knit it up in some other colors and try out some sizes. I think this is meant to be like 9 months to a year. But I'm not sure, as I said, because I have never tried my knitted garments on a baby, so I don't know. But yeah, I keep them in my basket. So when I find something that, or someone that it fits, I can totally like pour knitted garments over them. Yeah, that's all the baby knits I have been knitting for 1.5 years. Maybe, yeah. And I'm planning for some more. Maybe I can show you. I have been talking a little bit about this book. Unfortunately, it's only in Norwegian, as it is for now. This is from the Pickles Girls, the last book. So it's 60 new patterns that I have. So the bubble set that I'm knitting is from this book. And I must show you, it's so cute. The other baby kit I'm planning to knit after I have finished the bubble set. Where is it? Exciting to see me looking for a book. There it is. So this is the next thing I'm going to knit. It's a baby cardigan, hat and pants. So I'm really looking forward to knit this. I'm planning to knit mine with, I have bought Pickles Extra Fine Merino in like a caramel color and a nice brown, and then I'm planning to have like a spring green on this orange part. So the pants would be brown with green, and then caramel cardigan. But I need to knit my bubbles at first. I think it's quite a lot of nice patterns. I also like on the front you have some knitted shorts for a baby, which is quite cute, so maybe I will knit that too. Yeah. I can never never stop knitting baby knits. And they will, it feels like it will always come to you somewhere. So if I give it away or give it to charity or keep it for myself, it will always be enjoyable by someone, at least. So, tired bug. Yeah, so I see a lot of positive things with knitting baby knits. It keeps my mojo up so I can knit bigger projects, so I don't give up on them. And yeah, the satisfaction, I think it's really nice. So yeah, this will be a really short episode. Even I can feel in my throat that I have been talking and talking and talking, but I haven't been talking so for so long, I can see on the time. But maybe I should just say that I hope you will have a really, really nice weekend and nice week. I am actually free, or I'm not going to be at work for the next week. I have like Easter vacation, but I'm going to write my big essay, or start to write on it. But today and tomorrow I will just relax and fill up with some energy, because it has been like really, really stressful at work. So I will relax and knit my baby knits. And maybe start up some new cross stitch, and then I will have my family will come to visit on next Thursday, so, and they will be here all weekend, so I'm really looking forward to it. We're going to eat some delicious Easter food, and we're going to celebrate my birthday next Friday, so I will have to figure out some nice cake. So I feel like I really need some knitting and seeing my family. I haven't seen them since Christmas. So just eat nice food, talk a lot, knit a lot. It will be really exciting. My mother has been knitting an Icelandic tunic or dress almost. So I have some yarn for her, so I'm looking forward to see her progress. Yeah, so I'm having a really good week coming for me. So, and I hope it will be sunny and nice, so I can be out with the dogs walking. I'm alone with them this weekend. My boyfriend is visiting some friends in Sweden, so this weekend I will just have dog walks and knitting. And yeah, so if you want to contact me, maybe I should have said this in the beginning, if you want to contact me, you can find me as Chubby Pug Yarn on Ravelry. We have a Ravelry group called Chubby Pug Yarn Podcast. You can tag me as Distortion on Instagram. Some people do, and I think it's really nice to see what you're knitting. I saw this morning that Daisy knits a lot, and posted a picture with, she tried to knit with her cat in her lap, a really cute cat, by the way, you know how it feels. So I was really glad when I like checked my phone, it's like, oh, someone had tagged me. I really like that. So, and I have made some friends in the Ravelry group for like questions. If you have, or suggestions, if you have something you want me to talk about, if you want to know more about, I don't know, me, my work, knitting traditions in Sweden or Norway, or about my dogs, or I don't know, if you're curious about anything, don't hesitate to ask. You can ask down here in YouTube thread, or you can write in the Ravelry group. Subscribe if you want to see more of me. And give me a thumbs up. So take care and have a good weekend.